Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss about the formulae for adjoint of the matrix and basics about adjoint of the matrix and inverse, and in the next video I will discuss about the problems based on adjoint and inverse of the matrix. Now, what is the meaning of adjoint of the matrix? Suppose this one is the matrix A11, basically it's based on address. Suppose Aij is the cofactor of small aij. That means these are the values, it's cofactor matrix. What is the meaning of adjoint of A? Adjoint of A is basically the transpose of the cofactor matrix. You have to take transpose, convert first row into first column, then second row into second column, and third row into third column. I repeat again, you have to find the cofactors of all the elements of the square matrix. After then you have to take transpose, then that matrix is known as adjoint of A. Now it is the definition. Transpose of the cofactor matrix is known as adjoint of the matrix. This one is the most important one, many times asked in the examination this question. Now the first theorem is, suppose I multiply the matrix with its adjoint or adjoint with its matrix, then it is A determinant into I. Let us try to prove this. Suppose the matrix is 2, 1, 3, 5 and clearly its modulus is 10 minus 3, that is 7. And try to find out the cofactors. First cofactor is 5, then second cofactor is minus 3, and third cofactor is minus 1, then fourth cofactor is 2. We have already completed this exercise in the previous slide. Then adjoint of A. What is the meaning of adjoint? Cofactor matrix C11, C12, C21 and C22. It's transpose. It's 5 minus 3 minus 1, 2. Now find the transpose. Convert first row into first column and second row into second column. This one is adjoint. Then multiply this value with A. The value of A is 2, 1, 3, 5. And what about adjoint? It's 5 minus 1 minus 3, 2 calculated here. Then multiply 2 into 5, 10. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. 2 into minus 1, then 1 into 2. Simply, it's a simple multiplication we have completed in the chapter of matrices. Now the answer is 7, 0, 0, 7. 7 can be taken as common. The answer is 7 into 1, 0, 0, 1. What about 7? 7 is basically determinant of A. A into adjoint A can be written as determinant of A into I. Similarly, you can calculate adjoint A into A. When we shift these values, you can easily find out the answer, A determinant into I. The second topic is singular and non-singular. This type of question is also there in the examination. What is the meaning of singular matrix? If a determinant of the matrix is 0, then the matrix is known as singular. If the determinant is non-zero, then it's called non-singular. Now the theorem based on this particular topic, if A and B are non-singular matrices of the same order, order should be same, then AB and BA are non-singular of the same order. Not the values are same, basically they are of the same order, not the values. Suppose this one is the matrix A and this one is B. You can calculate A determinant. It's 4 minus 6. It's 12 minus 5. This value is 7 and this value is minus 2. Here A and B are non-singular because the value is not equal to 0. What about AB? Simply multiply this value. You can calculate this value is non-zero. And then BA, you can calculate the value. It's also non-zero. These values are not equal because AB is not equal to BA maximum times. Now theorem third, determinant of AB is equal to A determinant into B determinant. Let us try this one. Suppose The matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 2, 1, 3. First answer is 4 minus 6, it's minus 2. Second is 15 minus 2, it's 13. Then multiply AB. Simple multiplication is there, matrix multiplication. You will find 126 minus 152, it's minus 26. Now multiply separately these values is minus 2 into 13, it's minus 26. Both the values are same. The last topic of this video, square matrix A is invertible. Now what is the meaning of invertible? If we can find out inverse. If and only if A is non-singular. If A is non-singular, it means determinant of A is not equal to 0. It means we can write A into adjoint A, or adjoint A into A is equal to modulus of A or determinant of A into I. Now divide by determinant of A. We can write A into 1 over A adjoint A or 1 over A adjoint A into A is equal to I. Suppose the product of two matrices is equal to identity matrix. It means one matrix is inverse of the second matrix. This one is there. A into A inverse is equal to I. It means clearly this one is the inverse of A. It means we can write A inverse is equal to 1 over A mod into adjoint A. We will apply all these contents in next video, in next exercise. Thank you for watching.